Hurricanes are really big storms that start really small. Hurricane Katrina, which devastated New Orleans, had winds of 130 miles an hour. Most hurricanes that hit the U.S. start as small atmospheric disturbances off the coast of Africa. How does a slight fluctuation in the atmosphere become a monster storm? It happens in three stages. First, warm air and water vapor rise from the ocean's surface, forming a small cloud. As the vapor condenses into rain, it releases heat. This heat, in turn, creates more warm air, which rises higher and forms thunderclouds, which multiply. Next, a low pressure wave close to the ocean's surface sweeps across the thunderstorms. This pulls winds blowing close to the ocean's surface into the center of the thunderstorms. The winds create strong updrafts of air, dragging moisture up with them. Next, the thunderstorms become enormous. Then they start to spin counterclockwise under the influence of the Earth's rotation. Finally, as the spinning intensifies, the storm sucks up even more warm air and moisture. The now massive storm forms an eye, a vertical low-pressure tube at the center of the spinning mass. Once the eye forms, the storms become a blowing, rotating, downpouring hurricane. As big as the hurricane gets, large-scale winds moving high in the atmosphere will steer the storm along its ultimate path. Maybe toward you, but hopefully not. By the way, hurricanes, cyclones, typhoons, they're all the same thing. They're different words used in different parts of the world for the same kind of storm, a really windy one. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, this is Mark Fischetti.